Hey, do you need practical gifts that dad will love? Larry's gonna help you out. Now, before we get started with Larry showing you some of his favorite things, he walked in tonight from work with this box with explicit instructions that I not touch it and I not do anything with it, but I was to open it live on the program. I have absolutely no idea, zero, what is in this very large box. So I'm going to open it right now in front of all of you. This is my gift from my husband. Oh my word. What is, no! Oh my gosh! I can't get it out, hang on.
You want some help?
No, no, I got it, no, I think.
You don't want to mess up with it.
Oh my word. I'm so excited. Wait, I'm gonna lift it out. Okay, so. For those of you who don't know, I have mentioned maybe more than once on the program that we, when our oldest boys moved out, I had an air fryer. They borrowed the air fryer, which is okay. They were using it. And so I haven't seen my air fryer in like 9 months since they moved out. And I kind of wanted a new one. And so apparently Larry found this beauty for me. It is, you guys, this is a family-sized one. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Seriously. Okay, thank you to my amazing husband behind the camera.
Welcome.
It looks brand new. It's brand new.
I don't know that it's been used very much. A recipe book and the owner's manual.
Look at that. It's brand new. I don't think it's ever been used. I'm so excited. Best husband ever.
You want to hear the rest of the story? It was free.
Free? What?
It was free.
Are you serious? Free?
Free.
Oh my gosh.
My coworker's mom had this and was wanting to get rid of it, and she knew we wanted it. She told her mom, and her mom gave it to her and brought it into work today.
Oh my gosh.
For you.
Yay, I'm so excited. Hey, I'm Hope.
And I'm Larry.
From Under the Median. Hey, Father's Day is just around the corner, and we are talking tonight about gifts that dad will love. So Larry went around the house, he collected some things that he thinks not only are practical, but they're incredibly well made. So he is going to share them with you today.
Okay.
All right, go ahead. What's number one? We're going to go, by the way, we are going to go from the least expensive to the most expensive. So we've got some pretty low value, very reasonable items, and they go up a little bit from there. But so before we get started, let's talk about the fact that we are actually saying all of these items are frugal, right? Frugal, mm-hmm. Even though some of them cost a little bit of money. Now, before we get started, explain how we can say these things are frugal, but they still cost a wee bit of money.
Well, the way I would define frugal in relationship to these items is these are items that you'll pay one money for, and they will last you a long time. So rather than buying cheap things that you're replacing over and over again, you're going to buy some nice quality merchandise that will serve you well, will be very satisfactory, and will last. Therefore, in the long run, it's frugal.
That's right. So if you want to know more about how we really define frugality versus being cheap, we actually did a whole video on it, and we're going to link it above. You can watch it when you're done with this one. There'll be a link in the description of this video too. All right, Larry, take it away. What is your first item that you absolutely love?
Well, we've talked about this on previous videos. Yes. This is one of my favorite coffees. And now we're currently buying this from Sam's. But you can get this online as well. Mm-hmm. This is the Varena Street Coffee and the Mississippi Grog. Man, that is so good. I happen to like dark, rich coffees, and that's what this is. And this has kind of a butterscotch caramel hazelnut flavor. So it's really good. Good stuff.
Do you want me to read? I'm going to read the description in my radio announcer voice. A warm and inviting blend of butterscotch, caramel, and hazelnut. There you go.
All right.
Mississippi Grog, Varena Street.
It's good.
Item number two that you absolutely love is?
I really enjoy having an atomic clock. Now, it's not really an atomic clock. It's a radio-controlled clock. This clock gets its signal from WWV from Fort Collins, Colorado. That happens to be a shortwave station. When Hope and I were working in broadcasting, we didn't have these atomic clocks back then. What we did have was a shortwave radio, and I would almost twice a week, I would set my watch by that shortwave radio down to the second, because we had to be on our jobs exactly at the right time, and we had to do our programming at the right time. Well, you may not need quite that precise of timing, but this clock sets itself according to WWV, which is an international radio signal that gives exact time. It's called Greenwich Mean Time. So, this clock, now they don't make this brand anymore, but they still make plenty of these, and you can find them, of course, on Amazon.
Right. We'll have links in the description of the video, so you can just go right to the link and click on it, and it'll take you right to the Amazon.
Yeah, and this clock gives the day and the date and the temperature inside, and it has a module that you can put outside that will give you the outside temperature, and that's a common feature on these. And you can get it in Fahrenheit or Celsius. How about that for you Canadian and European people? So this I really like, because whenever I want to set my watch, I just set it by this clock.
Okay.
This is a wonderful item that we found about a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I love putting my coffee in a thermos. Now, we do some traveling. And so when we're in the cars, we like to have hot coffee. I take this to work with me. And this thermos will keep coffee hot for, I'm finding it keeps it pretty hot for 16 hours. It's guaranteed to do it for about 10. And it's really hot after 10 hours. I've never had a better thermos. And the brand, you better say that, Hope.
Zojirushi.
It's a Zojirushi brand, and it's made in Taiwan. And so it has a flip top. This cap locks. So
it does not leak.
It doesn't leak. Only if you leave the lid loose like I did this week, and it leaked all the way out to the car. That was my fault. But otherwise, no, it's really good. So that is a nice item.
Number four.
I would not be without one of these. And I think anybody that works in law enforcement will recognize this as a Maglite. But this is the small one. This one takes AA batteries. It's not real big. It's very bright. I think mine is, it's an older model, so I think mine's about 270 lumens. But the new ones go up past 350 lumens. And I can't imagine you wanting it much brighter than that, because you do have to, you can dial it down and kind of dim it down some, but it's very bright. This is so handy when you're in a store and you're in an area that's not well lit and you want to see an item. I take it out and light it up. If you have a power outage, I wear this on my belt. See, this has a carrying case, and it's just very handy to always have a light with you. You just never know when you're going to need a little extra lighting. So I carry that 24/7. Wonderful.
One of the things we talked about in one of the other videos, too, was that you carry this when we go thrift store shopping.
Oh, yeah.
Because the light shows up stains on things.
It does. And a lot of times a thrift store isn't well lit in some of the areas where you might have an item on a lower shelf and it's not lit very well from above. So this will light it up. I just get it out and use it all the time. I just can't tell you how many times in a day that I use this Maglite. It's great. Another item that we enjoy is a fire pit, and we'll show you some video of that. This is just a metal fire pit. It's not real big. We can put about four or five small logs into it, and it's very safe to use. So if you get sparks flying off, they're kind of caught in the screen. It's nice to have out on the back patio, and we use it for when we're out and it's a little bit chilly out, just to kind of warm up, sit around the fire pit. They're not real expensive, and it is kind of a nice item to have. And if you're in an urban environment, these are legal to have in your backyard. It's legal here where we live to have that, where you can't have an open fire. So a very nice thing to have. Not real expensive either.
Now, I will say one of the things that we wish our fire pit had but doesn't have is a flat top mm-hmm. that you could set like a cooking pot on, or even a grate that you could cook some things on. It just doesn't have that. But the one that we found on Amazon that we put a link to in the description of the video, that one actually does have, it has a grate. And so it makes it so that you can use it a little bit more readily for like cooking if you're going to do that. I mean, we roast like, you know, we make s'mores or whatever, you know, little things with ours, but it's not exactly designed for that.
The next item that I've had this for over a year now, and people probably have some of these. This is a JBL Charge 3. They now make, I think they make a Charge 5. I know they make a Charge 4. This is amazing. It's a small speaker. It's about 8 inches long. It's not real heavy. It has a nice rubber stand. You can set it on. This will run. I don't charge it very often. I think I only charge it maybe once every 2 weeks. It runs a long time on the batteries. I think it'll run almost 24 straight hours just on batteries alone.
And you use it a lot.
I do. Like a lot. I've got, this is an older SansaFuse MP3 player, and it just plays so nice with it. It does a great job. And this has some really serious booming bass. If you put this like inside of a bookshelf or a cabinet that has a little bit of wood enclosed, it sounds like a full-size stereo. So I really enjoy having this. This is also Bluetooth. So we will hook it up to the computer via Bluetooth and we'll listen to YouTube videos. This is a much better speaker than your computer comes with. A very nice thing to have. And like I say, I use this thing all the time.
It's really practical. I mean, we use it in so many different areas of the house.
I'll tell you another way that we used it on our vacation. I've got white noise recorded on this on a flash drive that I keep in that MP3 player. And white noise is just, it's just like snow. You know how television had snow or FM off channel? It's that kind of that static sound. Well, if you run that in your room, maybe you got a little extraneous noise going on. If you run that, it just kind of blanks everything out, and it makes it really nice to sleep with. And while we had a lot of people in the cabin that we were staying in, it was nice running that white noise. We could sleep, not hear a thing.
Yeah. So, I mean, people buy like white noise generators and this. So he figured out how to use it as a white noise.
Well,
generator.
The way you do it, I recorded the I recorded off of a portable television, the white noise. And then I run that. I loop the audio using the features on the MP3 player that allows you to repeat a song. I recorded it as just one song file. So that just repeats all night, and it'll run indefinitely that way.
You guys know how much he likes this? He bought me one.
I did.
That's how much he liked his speaker. I got one too.
Yeah, So we got one
right,
for home.
Yeah, we actually highly recommend that. All right, so, and the next thing that we really, well, you super duper like, you guys, he probably, I can't tell you all of the ways that he expressed his love for this thing while we were on our vacation.
This is kind of older technology because iPhones and other smartphones have kind of taken over this this role, but this is a Garmin. I just purchased this this year because my Honda Fit did not come with built-in navigation, and I don't happen to own a smartphone. I've got a work phone. It's a flip phone, and it does two amazing things. It'll do a little bit of texting, and I can actually make phone calls with it. But we don't really have, I don't have an iPhone, so when I'm by myself, I wanted something that I could navigate with, and this does a super job. You can program, of course, your destinations in it. You can save those. It gives you the speed on a highway. If you're on a highway, it'll tell you what the speed is. If the speed's changing, it gives you those changes. You can find restaurants and gas stations and in your local area. While we were in Tennessee, we used this to find gas stations, and then it would direct us to them. So very, very handy to have. And I'll tell you why it's a little bit of an advantage over an iPhone. You're not tied up. Maybe you have to make a phone call. Well, then you have to disconnect your navigation and make a phone call. This way you can still use your iPhones and have this just dedicated on the dashboard. This is a beanbag bracket that I bought separately that just holds that on the dash. The van that we rented did not have any navigation. So this came in handy while we were driving around areas that we were not familiar with. And it gives you the time to the projected time that you're going to get to your destination and the mileage. So very nice feature to have. It also will direct you on the highway. It'll even tell you which lanes you need to be in. If you're on interstate, it'll tell you you need to be in the two right-hand lanes in order to turn off at this exit. And that's something these old people like me, I used to use a map. Maps won't tell you that, but this is really handy. It was worth every penny.
Now, one of the things it also did was it told us where there were lane slowdowns. It told us where there was construction. It'd say, you got to get in this lane because the right lane's blocked off ahead. It told us when there was an accident. It's like, accident reported 20 minutes
ago.
Well,
this model, this is the Model 55, and it has traffic reports built into this. So the Model 55 and the Model 65 will give you that. I opted for the 55 because it was quite a bit less expensive, and this is a big enough screen. The Model 65 had a 7-inch screen, and this has a 5.5-inch screen.
That seemed plenty big to me.
It was plenty good size to see, yeah.
Now, there's one other thing, and this is an optional thing. So the GPS unit, the Garmin was one thing, and then this is optional.
That's a
separate item.
So. And it's made for the Garmin, so it has the special Garmin mount. It has to have that kind of like, looks like a ball bearing on the end of it to fit into that bracket mount. I bought two separate ones. This is a cup holder. It just happens that my Honda Fit has a cup holder up high and on the left side. I don't use it. And it's perfect height for this to sit, and I can read it, and it's below the windshield level, so it's not getting in the way or impeding my visibility looking out the front.
And that was optional, too. So this was something you bought separate as well.
Yeah, and you just turn this dial, and it expands to fit nice and tight into your existing cup holder. You can get different ones. You can get some that are longer if you're putting it in a cup holder that's down low. So there's different kinds. This comes with an attachment. It's a suction cup that attaches to your windshield, but it tends to fall off. Now, that's been my experience with it, and that's been the experience of the people who were rating this on Amazon. They said that could be a little bit of a problem with it. So, love this unit. It's great.
Now, remember, there's links to all of these. Everything he's showing you, there are links in the description of the video, so you can find those. Now, there's one other optional thing that that you wanted to make sure that you showed them. And he was like, I want to show this because this is like really important.
A coworker got me on to these batteries. These are Eneloop batteries. They used to be made by Sanyo. Now Panasonic is distributing these. These are the best rechargeable batteries I've ever seen on the market. They don't lose their charge. Once you charge them, they'll hold a charge for over a year. They're rated at holding at least 70% of the original charge after a year of non-use. But I use these in my digital camera. My Canon takes four of these, and I use them in the Maglite. And I also use them in a device that we use to raise and lower the camera remotely. I use it in that. So these are excellent batteries. They're not terribly expensive. And once again, Amazon has these. Really good.
And this was, and that's one of the things. So some of you all mentioned rechargeable batteries. When we just recently did a video on things that we stock up on, and batteries is actually one of those things. And several of you said, you know, I just really use rechargeables. And so, mm-hmm. I mean, clearly we do too for specific things that we know we're going to use them often, we're going to use them hard, then we use the rechargeables. But we always keep a stock of the traditional non-rechargeable batteries on hand as well. So we actually use both.
And the thing that I have found with these is that they will last you several years. You can get hundreds of recharges on these, and they're just the very best. I've used other brands, and my experience with them is that when I wanted to use the item, it would be run down. I'd have to charge it up again. Not so with these.
And these were a few of his favorite things. That's Larry's list of items that he has that he thinks are long-lasting, practical, well-made, and most importantly, frugal. But we want to hear from you. What are your ideas for gifts that Dad will love? Hey, leave us comments in the comments section, give the video a thumbs up, and make sure that you are subscribed. And when you do, hit that bell notification button, because that's the way that YouTube will tell you every time that we drop a new video. Do you need practical gifts that Dad will love? We're here to help. I don't like the way I said that.
I don't either. It sounded condescending.
Hey, I'm Hope.
And I'm Larry.
From Under the Median. Hey, if this is your first time with us, we raised our four sons debt-free on an income which was less than average. And along the way, we
did do that some.
We did some. We did. More than once did we. All right. Those are Larry's favorite things. We want to know in the comments section, what are your favorite things? These are things that are designed for guys that the dad or the loved person. Take three.
She's tired.
Yes, I am. All right. Leave us some comments, some love in the, this just sounds so stupid. Leave us some.
This is a photo of a good friend of mine named Harry Harrison. He worked at the station that Hope worked at, WPEO Radio, from 1955 to 1959, when it was a top 40 station. He went on to the New York City market and worked at WMCA, WABC, and WCBS FM, where he retired in 2006.